Morning! Hello! Welcome to a new Walt Disney World vlog series. My friend Gary and I are heading to Walt Disney World for 10 days, which we are very excited about. If you are new to the channel, hello, my name is Adam. Make sure to subscribe down below because I've got lots of new Disney vlogs on the way, which I hope you're really going to enjoy. This has been a long time coming. My friend Gary and I booked this trip a while ago and we're very excited about the adventures that we have in store. We've got lots of new dining reservations, lots of new things to experience, Star Wars Land, namely. And yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. There's a couple of surprises in store for Gary, which is why I'm starting this vlog at home and not at the airport hotel. So we're going down to the airport hotel tonight, which is the Hilton, staying overnight and then flying out tomorrow with Virgin Atlantic. And as far as Gary understands, we're in economy right at the back of the plane. However, we're flying premium economy and we're in the bubble, which is like the second floor of the plane. And Gary's not the biggest fan of flying. He really struggles from a mental health perspective and the fact that he's quite tall, he doesn't really get comfortable. And I'm really hoping this makes the world of difference. I'm very excited. I've been lucky enough to have a premium economy seat before and I think Gary's really gonna enjoy it, so that's the first surprise. I'm going to plan to tell him just before check-in, so hopefully that goes to plan. And the second surprise is that he thinks we're staying at Pop Century, and he has every right to think that because that's what we booked, and I sent him the booking confirmation so he could see it, obviously. And that was like 8 months ago. And because I have an annual pass, about 3 months before you travel, you can sometimes get an annual pass discount. So which is why I tend to book my trips last minute, just because that's when the annual pass discount is out. But I called up and I said, hi, we've got a reservation. And I was just wondering if there's an annual pass discount I could apply. And the cast member very kindly said yes. And I'll also let you know that room rates have been reduced recently, so you're going to save a bit of money. And I was like, oh, okay. Well, whilst I've got you on the phone, with all these discounts and stuff, how much would it cost to stay at Portland's Riverside? And there was almost no difference in it. So I was like, okay, let's book it. So we're staying at Portland's Riverside. We stayed there in 2016. It was one of my, well, it is one of my favorite hotels. Gary thinks it's probably the best hotel that we've stayed at together. So I'm really excited to tell him about that. I don't think he'll expect it either because we obviously stayed there before. So, a couple of surprises. Can't wait. I'm leaving very soon. I've just got to walk Eddie,
my gorgeous boy, who I'm going to miss very much.
And just put some last bits and bobs in my case. And then getting to Gatwick is a bit of a pain for me because I'm about a 2.5 hour drive away. And because I share a car, I can't take the car. Getting there via public transport or taxis and stuff is very expensive and very kerfuffly. Well, actually, a train's not too bad, it's just it's very kerfuffly. Trying to take, like, potentially 3 bags on the London Underground or, like, trying to go around London is just, it's just a bit of a nightmare. But anyway, we will move on. We will go to Disney. We'll go to the airport first and then we'll go to Disney and just, yes. Ah, I'm so excited. Just got into London. I'm now in a black cab on my way to London Victoria Station to get the Gatwick Express. And I'm enjoying my little scenic view of London with my CIB checked black cab driver. I don't actually know your name.
Adam.
Adam?
Adam.
I'm Adam too.
Oh, lovely.
That's easy.
Adam's
been telling me all about the black cab business and everything and how they're like CRB checks and stuff, because I haven't taken the black cab in like 15 years, so it's been really cool and all my cases fit in here very nicely. Made it to Victoria, just waiting for Gary to arrive. Hopefully he should be here in just a moment. Really nice cab driver, he was really cool and it was kind of nice taking a London cab, I felt like a right tourist. It was just I'm wondering there.
Listen, I'll have you know, that is a puppet, that's not just a bird.
I was going to call it a pelican but I didn't know what it was.
No,
so
it's a puppet.
I said I'm under the Spitfire sign with a bird on it.
Yeah, not just any bird, a puffin. Hello vlog, how are you? Welcome to the new series. Subscribe, hit that notification bell. Everyone's favourite promotional plane is here. I made this for me.
Gary is here. We're waiting for our platform number to come up. Funnily enough, because Gary's train was delayed, we missed our train to Gatwick. But it's fine. There's a train every half an hour from Gatwick on the Gatwick Express, which is good. Hopefully our tickets are both valid.
This is the face they're going to get now, just all the time.
I'm present!
I'm here, but I'm thinking about Disney World. I'm thinking about Star Wars Land.
Yeah, we are very excited for Galaxy's Edge. We've got a whole
He says the actual name and I say Star Wars Land!
Yeah, it's fine, you can call it Star Wars Land. We've got an abundance of new dining reservations we've never done before. And the theme is new.
The vlog series is new. New things.
Basically, we've been doing this for...
Well, you've been doing this a long time.
Well, yeah, but how many times have we been now? This is number five? Five to Disney World. And even in that amount of time, we've ended up getting into a system of doing the same things. And we're trying to break that habit this trip by doing completely different things. So, we're only new.
New shows, adjustments to shows, Skyliner, you name it, it's all coming
new
in this vlog series.
Yep. So, it's going to be fun. We're heading to Gatwick, obviously you already know that, but then we're going to go check into the Hilton for our overnight stay and hopefully get some dinner at Giraffe.
Oh, Giraffe you say?
Giraffe. Oh yeah, you love a giraffe.
I love a giraffe.
Yeah girl, next stop, Disney World!
Did someone say Wi-Fi? Hi Wi-Fi!
They're Wi-Fi? Oh. Oh, I've got two cases for the very purpose of, Gary and I always struggle coming back. It's either overweight or can't fit it all in. So I thought, pack an extra case.
Who knew that pins cost so much weight?
I did. When you spent $450 last time.
I spent more than that actually. It's only what I told you. Yeah.
So we've got our own little cabin. Good afternoon. Oh my God. Oh no, we haven't.
What?
There's someone there. Bags are in.
Oh, do you want to go next to the window?
That bag's in.
What bag?
The old bag.
The scandal.
There isn't actually anyone in this carriage. There's a reflection from another train, but I was like, oh my God, what have I done? So.
What?
You haven't even started yet.
But I wanted the sweet. You sweets?
No. No sweets for you. Broccoli.
Broccoli?
Yeah, they can have broccoli.
I actually like broccoli. Still thinking about Star Wars.
You are? You really excited for it?
Oh yeah. Oh, I love Star Wars. I'm wearing a Star Wars t-shirt that I made as well.
She's an artsy craftsy girl. I've got a new carry-on case. I normally just carry my rucksack that's probably about the same size as Gary's. But I decided to carry a little bit extra stuff. This is from Samsonite. I got a very good deal. I think this is Abyss Village.
Oh wait.
It was originally, I think it was like £300 or something like that, and I got it for £80, which is still an expensive bag, don't get me wrong. But the reason I liked this case in specifically is because I travel a lot. It's very well made. It has a very nice laptop case down here, so I can, it's nice and padded. Pop lots of stuff in there, pop documents in there. It has a nice front document section, which I'm, can you stop rustling with your pom bears, please?
I was like, whisper gold about.
I would actually like some pombears. But anyway, whilst back to my bag, this lovely front pocket has a nice document section, which allows you to kind of have all your documents in there, little pen, pad. I've got some paracetamol if necessary. I've got my little documents holder, which has my passport in it. I've got my portable charger because Fuel Rod are going to start charging people for re-energizes. So I was like, no. And then it's got a nice big pocket, which is essentially the same size as a cabin thingy majiggy. Yeah, well, I don't know why I'm holding this.
Human tripod there. Hello, welcome to the show. So, what's in my carry-on? I'm not that type of vlogger, am I? But what's in my carry-on? Stop it! Oh my God!
I told you I bought loads of little snacks for the room. When
you
we
said I brought snacks. You didn't say I brought loads of little snacks.
Yeah, I bought loads.
You know there are shops at Gap. There's shops at the
end. Hello, there, gentlemen. This train's full of 12 coaches. Please use the full length for this service. Do not be afraid to use the front three coaches. There is no alligators or anything up there. In fact, they're quite pleasant. They're nice and quiet.
Is there not?
We do have three first-class compartments, all of which...
Oh, that's it. Ruin the joke by not focusing. Damn you.
So, what's in my carry-on?
Let's find out. I've got a nice big compartment here, which is almost the same size as like one of those little wheelie cases, but I need a rucksack, especially if I'm bringing two cases because I've got a wheelie them. I've got notepad.
Oh,
one,
yeah.
One for Gary.
Everything is going to be okay. Yes, it is Star Wars Land.
That's what he can read when we're hurtling to the ground.
That's what he can
Excuse
read.
Excuse me, human tripod.
I was obviously looking,
pointed at the floor.
Looking at my book.
Up, come on.
Oh my God, this is torture.
Pack of tissues. What do you think I'm bringing you on the holiday? For fun. You've got angles to capture, darling. I've got my noise-cancelling headphones, which I'm going to let Gary try out, because I think he'll absolutely love these.
You let me try them, love them, and take them away.
Yeah. I've got my little plastic baggie that they give you before you go in. I always like to keep this to stop using a new one. So it's now reusable, it's not a single use.
Save the turtle, save the whale.
Exactly. I've got this new hand sanitizer that I got from Norway when Rachel and I went on our cruise by Touchland, and I believe it's cinnamon and vanilla flavoured. Flavoured? Scented. I like to find little things that...
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Please use full length. This service forms 12 coaches, 24 doors to get on, not just the...
Is this your new camera?
Got on. Please do use the full length for this service.
Really high quality.
I know, 4K.
You're filming in 4K?
I'm filming in 4K.
Well, you could have walked
well,
me that.
I don't know if I am.
Don't
because
know.
I might have...
Shushed it.
It films in 4K, but when I edit it, it goes down to 1080.
So it looks really good.
I'm filming on the Canon G7X Mark III, which I got for my birth... Well, I didn't really get it for my birthday. I had to trade in my old one because it broke like two or three times. And I said to them, I was like, I don't want to keep repairing it, because it kept getting dust in the lens, so they...
I'm trying to get a sweet and be still at the same time!
Anyway, sweet. They ended up giving me like a partial refund of the camera, even though I'd had it for like a year. So I got 400 something pounds back to put that towards a new camera. As part of like a joint birthday present. Partly for myself, partly for my parents. Right. Magic band, obviously. Soft mints. Water bottle, dino dump.
Oh yeah.
And spare batteries, watching the jiggers, and a pair of shorts to change into when we're on the flight. And that's what's in my carry-on.
Well, my name's Andy. I'll be your onboard supervisor for your trip today. Trains full of 12 coaches, ladies and gentlemen. Please make full use of this. Please use every single seat. Keep bags and coats off seats, as people like seats, bags and coats.
Say it looks like Gatwick?
Yeah.
It's because we are in Gatwick.
Oh, this is actually the airport. I thought this was just a train bit. I was like, oh, they've done a good job matching them, haven't they?
Oh my God. So I normally stay...
What are you doing?
I normally stay at Block Hotel, which is up there. We're going to go to Giraffe for dinner over there as well, but we're going to the Hilton, which is just across the way from the South Terminal.
When he asked the man where the Hilton was, he went left there, left there, right there, down there, and he looked at me and went, did you get that?
No.
So we're heading out of the terminal this way, and then we're going to go down a floor and then across the car. I don't know, we'll find it. Momo Shiroo!
Momo Shiroo!
Look there! I'm French now!
So they've got like a little bridge. So it's level one of the car park essentially. To get this far.
From you froze. Do you know what? The whole world could go into chaos and there'd be a Costa just springing up out of the floor.
This is the hotel, yeah.
This is really nice.
Very American hotel, isn't it?
It is. It actually does feel like it's American.
It smells like Orlando International Airport, weirdly.
Yeah, it smells like the one we stayed at California in 2015.
We're on the fourth floor. So there's an executive lounge there.
Where?
Maybe Shrew.
There's Adam, there's Adam, there's Adam, there's Gary, there's Adam, there's Adam and Gary. If you're self-conscious, beware the lift.
The corridors are a bit eerie.
Come play with us.
Yay! The TV's on and all the lights are off, which makes me think someone's in the room.
Haunted!
I said, what did I say to her?
You said to her, what's the view? Is it car park and more, but more spacious car park? And then she was like, yeah, I'm not gonna lie.
You might find an odd tree if you're lucky. So our oh, we've got large car park.
Oh, wow.
With the spirals, lovely.
I'm guarding the door.
Do you wanna give us a room tour?
All right, you don't like my room tours though.
It's... Why don't I like your room tours?
Because this is like, well, this is nice. This is just been bleached like that. I like that. I'm like a sniffer dog for the clean. No hairs in the bath. That's one thing that makes me feel sick if I see that.
Yep.
Let me agree. Just check.
It looks a bit dated, but it is clean.
It does. It looks very old school swimming pool baths. You know when you go to the swimming pool and then those that look.
Oh, triggered. No, let's not go there.
Oh, little things.
I think there's a wardrobe in here, which is quite nice.
Oh, look.
Oh, it's a fridge. I was expecting to like open this and like find some.
That was a shredder. I was like, what are people up to in here?
So it's a hairdryer, ironing, iron, safe, fridge.
Oh, look what I have.
What? Thermostat for thermal control. We've got a twin room. Bedside table. Chest of drawers. There's some tea making equipment down there. We will put that to good use. Oh, it slides out. How lovely. No biscuits, though.
Always a pen. Is Penn allowed to leave said premises?
Of course.
Yeah, it's all right. It will do the job.
It is dated.
Yeah, I like it.
This was the same price as staying at the Premier Inn in North Terminal, and after my Premier Inn experience at the one in King's Cross before we took our trip to Disneyland Paris, I was like, I'd rather have like a proper hotel that has like proper nice tea and coffee stuff, a fridge. Well, the towels like. That's how I like to judge a room.
Oh, right. I thought you were cleaning us.
Towels.
Not bad. Like, same quality as Disney, I'd say.
I love the fact you touched the towels. Towel toucher.
Adam Hattan, towel toucher.
Which bed do you want? The wall or the...
Well, considering you've already claimed this bed.
Oh, no, that's not claimed. That was just...
Do you want that bed, then?
That was just resting.
Whatever. They're slightly bigger than a single, though, aren't they?
I'd rather not be near the aircon because you tend to have it on like Arctic.
No, country. I don't.
He does. He's like a cold.
No, I don't. He's... I sleep warm.
Do you?
Yeah.
So why do I have the aircon on all the time?
I don't know.
Lizard. Lizard person.
I like it warm enough. I also like it cool enough.
One big happy planet. Oh, they do like recycling and stuff. Bath towels. Reuse your bath towels. Oh, they all say that.
Because I don't want to clean them. Right, we're gonna. We don't really need to unpack because we're staying here.
We don't need to freshen up or unpack. So now we're gonna go get something to eat. Shush.
They have one of those like breakfast order forms on the back of the door, and I looked at it and I was like, oh, should we look at the view? I looked at it and I was like, oh, they can you order breakfast, $20.95, and Kerry was like,
ooh.
She loves a view. It does very much smell like Florida, but I can't put my finger on it.
It's like one of the quick services in one of the places. That's what it smells like. It's a mixture of food and people coming and going.
Like the land, maybe?
Maybe. I'm already thinking, staying overnight at an airport. Yes, this is peace. Peace.
Well, you were the biggest...
I was like, no, waste of money. Just get there. No.
Oh, wait. It says arrivals and train station that way. Is maybe quicker this way?
Yeah.
Who knows?
Which way did we come?
We came from that way, but...
We love a bit of witchcraft. Magical doors.
So already you're the converted. You would Happily stay at a hotel.
Definitely stay in a hotel.
Any reason why?
Just because of the convenience. It's so much easier. And like, if you've got kids in that, the drama and the saga. Because I've been to Disneyland Paris with my nephew and niece and the whole family. And having a stayover where you can just walk to the airplane and everything, it just makes it so much easier.
I would
yes,
agree.
Yes, it's coins, but I mean, coins and peace of mind.
Good. More like it, peaceful.
If I was an Imagineer, I'd make these in Disney Worlds everywhere.
You said you don't like these.
I changed my mind. It's 5 seconds ago. I could change my mind in 5 seconds.
Literally 20 minutes difference to when we last came in, and it was absolutely heaving.
Peace
be with you. Giraffe.
Giraffe.
For appetizers, Gary got the teriyaki chicken salad, which looks amazing.
Yeah,
it's really good. And I got the halloumi fries. Nom nom nom.
But I have to share this though, that's too much for me. That's
like, no, I'll help. I'll happily help. It looks really good though. What do you think of the salad?
Really lovely.
Yeah. I haven't given these a go yet.
Yeah. I've actually taken a lactose pill, so this will be the first time you see me eating cheese. Well, with no consequences. So this is what halloumi is. This is what everyone's been going on about.
It's really good.
It's good, isn't it?
Buttery, crispy, chewy goodness. This looks good.
It is good. I like it.
Ooh. The real question is, how does this measure up with Wagamama's? I'd say it's more chicken tikka masala-y than it is catsup, but good.
I've finished my food. I have to say, Giraffe, you lay on a lot of gear. That is a lot of food. But chicken burger was lovely. The chips, well, you can tell for yourself, not nice. So I would say pay the extra pound and get the sweet potato fries to mix it up, because there's not much taste in these and they're a bit...
Yeah. And I paid £3 extra for some vegetable gyoza. Not very nice. I was a little bit disappointed in those, but the curry itself was good. A member of staff was like, oh, you didn't like the vegetable gyoza? And I was like, no, sorry, it wasn't for me. And I was like, oh, I'll take them off, don't worry about it. So that was nice.
Oh, really nice, that's nice. Hey, Mac and Cheese, if you're listening, do that.
Mackie D's.
You don't call Mackie D's Mackie D's?
Yeah, but what are they going to do?
Oh, this chicken sandwich is rather dry.
For free. Review.
Nice. Dear for what it is. But they give you a lot of food. Actually, that's a lie. They give you
a lot
of food.
We had a starter and a main each. And I had two Cokes, you had one Coke, and it was £25 each-ish.
That's not that bad.
No.
Not in a... airport.
No, so I was pleasantly surprised by it.
Yeah, the guy who served us was really lovely. I wish we got his name.
The man
was good. He got a good tip.
I'm going to pop into Marks and Spencer's because they have a white chocolate milk, which is just to die for.
Did someone say treats?
Did someone say boring? Yeah. Water.
Agua.
Aquafina.
What?
I don't know.
Are you alright?
I'm having a funny turn. I just want to be in Star Wars land.
I've got my energy back now that I've eaten. Before I was kind of like, oh, I'm losing it.
Happy returns.
Happy. Sounds like me.
Sounds Bev.
Maybe I was doing the copy. Wrote the copy for that.
We're winding down for bed. Giraffe was nice. And... I think there's not really any else other places to eat, so it was... Do you want to tell the people what you did?
I may have...
Not may, you did.
I did. Booked my travel insurance a day less than I needed, so I've got to ring up the people tomorrow.
Because I said to him, I was like, we fly out on the 9th, but we arrive back in the UK on the 10th, and he booked it for ending on the 9th.
Hello, I'm Gary Stee. This is what I do.
You can imagine what my experience is like travelling with this one. So yeah, we're just going to wind down, watch some telly, and we will see you for full travel day tomorrow. Morning! It is Disney Day!
I'm a ghost.
Boo.
It's Coronation Day!
Hooray!
Yay! We've been looking forward to this for so long.
How did you sleep?
Not great. I woke up at like 3:30 and then was awake for 2 hours trying to get back to sleep. You didn't sleep at all, did you? You did.
I slept on and off.
I heard you.
But the snoring. But the beds are really comfortable.
Beds are really comfortable. Shower, not good. It has two settings. Volcano hot or Atlantic cold.
Oh, I love to be scalded in the mornings.
Arctic cold.
That's my favourite look. Red and fur.
Like your kink or something. Like, to be scalded in the morning.
Lobster lady look.
So yeah, it's not great. Like, let me just show you what it... Like, what is that? You can't wash anything with that. Oh, get myself wet. Like, so, don't move that one if you don't.
Don't oversell it. I've got to do this in a minute.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, don't touch that one, because you'll burn yourself, or you'll get cold.
I love the look.
I managed to get it
Put me in the middle. Tank, I'm done.
Anyway, we're going to finish getting ready, and then we've got to check in for our flight in an hour.
Still a pumpkin just for me.
We are about to head over to the airport. Review of this hotel is that I probably wouldn't stay in it again. Gary made the mistake of dropping his anxiety ring underneath the bed last night, which meant we had to look underneath the bed. And girl,
there was a hairy gummy bear under there.
Gerald.
What did we call him? Lucifer will do. It's the work of the devil.
And like looking at the carpet, it's really not that clean. And everything's like dings and old and stuff, so... I don't know. I'd prefer to stay at Block.
How much was it?
Same price as Block, about £90 for the night. So, it's not bad for what it was for two of us to have a twin room, but at the same time, I'd probably find somewhere else next time.
But at the same time, Lucifer put you off. Oh, Lucifer, you little beast.
Are you right there?
The struggle is real, viewers. The struggle is... Struggle? I've got my little card. I'm not going to keep this one.
Well, you
not
can't.
Because, not because I'm being shady. Just because... Who cares?
This is the part you said you were looking forward to, is the door closing behind us. So that means we're going to Florida.
We're going to Disney World. Unless I can't get out with these voices. All right, girls.
Right. That's it. Bye, girl.
Right, back to the shining...
So we were at the South Terminal. We need to take a tram over to the North Terminal.
So once we've moved Sherwood over there, that's right, I've said it now. Then...
No, that's not what Moo Sherwood is. Moo Sherwood is like treat yourself.
Moo Sherwood?
Yeah.
In the Gary definition, is we're just going to have a little Moo Sherwood over there. Little nose around.
Right.
Little cheek. Oh, you got that on.
We're all going on a Disney holiday.
Right out here.
What?
You don't know this. But he just tripped over himself.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Welcome to the shuttle to Gatwick North Terminal.
We will tell you a little bit about the flight. We are flying with Virgin Atlantic. What class are we in?
We're in economy, we're at the back in the little two, so that's good. No weirdos next to us.
That's the thing.
What?
I've been lying to you.
No, you're joking.
We are flying premium economy.
No!
To and from Orlando.
No!
In the bubble upstairs.
No!
Yes!
Oh my God! Oh my God!
Surprise!
So when I said to you last night, I wonder how much it is to upgrade, because it'll be so much better, and you just sat there quiet.
I was like, no, it's never going to happen. Like, the charger on Earth in the world, so... Ta-da!
Oh my God.
Your first time in premium economy.
I know.
So I've got to tell you before we get to the desk, we've got to go to the premium economy desk. And we've got priority boarding, we've got extra leg room, we've got nice bigger TVs, we get a cup of tea and a mug. Treat yourself.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It's been a ruse.
Oh my God, I can't believe it. Down to wearing jeans. It's all been a thing. I even said to Adam just now, I'll actually enjoy this flight. Even though I'm not afraid of flying, I just think it's really uncomfortable and just a mission. But if I've got that extra leg room, I might be able to actually sort of sit there and be like...
We get a footrest, darling.
Oh, footrest?
Mmm.
Oh, I need a little crown.
Oh! I saw it, don't worry. Right, so we're going to go to the premium economy desk and check in.
Just took a picture of the desk. Might never do this again. Got my little device.
Got priority security as well. And then we've booked number one lounge. I actually booked the number one club lounge.
Oh.
Which is the nicer one. I haven't done it at the North Terminal. I did it at the South Terminal. I was flying by myself and it was really nice. So hopefully we can... Because we looked at the...
I walk in, they'll go, this old scrubber, out.
We got sent the menu by Virgin early to like choose what we want, because they're obviously trying to reduce waste and this, that and the other. And even the three options we had weren't that fantastic. But in the club level, you get like... In the club lounge, sorry, you get nicer... things. I managed to get an offer code last time, or like an affiliate link or something, so if I can find something like that, I'll drop it in the link below if you want to book your own club lounge. We'll obviously let you know what we think about it, because it's our first time, so. Alright, goodbye people. It's time for security. How was your premium security experience?
Amazing. We were done in 2 minutes, and the lady on the door, she read my t-shirt and went, still a pumpkin, always a bridesmaid. I was amused.
Do you need to pick up anything?
No.
Should we just go straight to the lounge?
Let's go to the lounge.
The lounge.
Let's give luck.
So, I'm not sure what we get in the lounge. We might get some bottles of water that we can take on. If not, we can just buy them and Dunbar Smith or something before we go to the plane.
Yeah, this is very nice. It's a Harry Potter shop.
Do you want to look?
Yeah.
We are going to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter at some point, so.
We are. They might have pins. And so it begins.
What did you do?
Slytherin! Oh, it's only a tenner.
What is?
Please be a sketchbook. No, damn.
What's the damage?
Pins. Guess how much they were each?
Expensive?
Cheap. This is the place to go for Harry Potter stuff. £2 each.
No way!
Yeah, everything is cheap in here. This is the Congress.
Hang on, it's not focusing.
This is the Congress medal. The insignia or like emblem, and then I've actually bought the other ones full price in the other shops. Muggleworthy. £2 each, that is a deal. Get on down to the Harry Potter shop. Come on down.
Hashtag not spun. To the lounge.
Oh, I'm a bougie girl now.
All right, we're going down to club rooms, which is level number one. So they have three lounges here. They have the My Lounge, which is that one. That's the cheapest of the three. Then you have number one lounge, which is the one that we did last time. And we're going down to the club rooms.
Oh, got the doors open.
Oh, yeah.
We've got our own little house.
We have got our own little house. We've got this nice little room, which is very nice. We've been given the menus, which I will show you now. La la la. So this is the breakfast menu. I'm pretty sure it switches over to lunch at some point. We've got our own TV that we can change the channel off, and I will show you around the rest of the lounge as well. They have a help yourself station for bottles of water, tea and coffee. I'm exposing you for your croissant.
Look, I'm obsessed with croissants. If you've seen Adam's vlogs before, you'll know there's one going. I'm on it. I'm French now. Bonjour.
Bon appetit, baby. Yours looks great.
Looks very nice, doesn't it?
Avocado, veggie sausages, toast.
If that avocado is not enough for you, then you can have mine.
No, no, that's fine. I've got plenty. Right.
The review of the club room is good.
I'm
amazing.
I think this was, I think a normal club room was £32, and I think this was £40 or £42. I think the standard of food is definitely better than what we had in number one lounge last time, because you had like beans on toast or something.
Yeah, this time it was like avocado on toast. Live your best life.
Yeah. And they do a lunch menu which I think starts after 11, but we just had our breakfast and have been quite content in that. We've enjoyed our little cocoon.
Our little hut. Our little separate little hut. We've met some people as well.
Yep.
On our flight. We've met quite a few people already actually. But yeah, it's gonna be an experience for me.
Right, gate 566.
Wow. What's this? Club Aspire, is that another one?
That's I think that's a members club.
Call me a member.
It's funny how this WH Smith is more expensive than every WH Smith we've ever been into in our lives.
Even the ones at train stations.
So I picked up some hula hoops, some crunchy rocks, and some
For
Pringles.
Example, guess how much they are? They're £1 in your local shop. £2.99.
Daylight robbery. What else you got?
Obviously the pom bears.
Yep.
And I always have these on a flight because these are my little treat.
Treat myself.
£4.97 for a pack of Mentos, pom bears, and a Haribo.
Well, mine came out reasonable. Like for the fact that I got a magazine, hula hoops, Pringles, chopped up rocks, and something else, and that was £12.
Haribo, what you playing at, girl?
Right, we're heading to the gate now. Much excitement.
Much excitement. Disney
going
well.
Going premium economy for the first time, Gary saying.
So there's a nice long line here, but not for us. We've got priority boarding line down here.
We're flying with Jersey Girl today. Jersey Girl?
Jersey Girl.
No wait, no nothing.
Just walking up.
But I think that's everyone. There's no waiting space back there, is there?
No, everyone's just getting on it.
Look, on you go, girl. Touch that, lovely. Hello.
I believe we're upstairs.
Yeah, and can't be easy, don't splash.
Oh, thanks. That made me laugh.
Be careful with the jacuzzi, don't smash.
It's nice of it.
Thank you.
No bother.
23 CNA. Here we go. So, this is premium economy. We have a headphones blanket and pillow when we arrive. This is the back of the chair, and in the bubble you get a nice little shelf down there, and I'm having the window seat for the first time in like 7 years. Love it. Oh yeah. First impressions of premium economy? For someone who's never done it before.
It's incredible. There's so much more space. I know, it's really weird. Like, I feel like I'm not going to be flying. Because usually I just associate flying with being really contained and claustro. But this seems so much more wider and like there's more depth. And also the screens, because they're bigger and you tilt them, you can just comfortably like watch it rather than like, that's why I don't watch anything on planes. So I always feel like I'm leaning in. I just can't bear it, but this is incredible. I do like the complimentary juice, you know,
yep,
like a little
yep,
juice.
We had a choice of Prosecco or orange juice. We both went with orange juice.
This is the staving off a cold juice, because I can feel the cold coming, so I'm like, give me the vitamin C.
Hello, there. We're delighted to welcome you aboard Virgin Atlantic. Thank you for flying with us today. You're no doubt keen to lose yourself in our dazzling world of entertainment, but first we're going to show you a safety film, and we'd like you to give it your full attention. It's really important that you watch and understand it, because together we're all responsible for safety on this flight. It helps explain the safety equipment and procedures of this particular aircraft, and gives you an idea of what to do in an emergency.
So we are flying on the 30th of September. These are the films they currently have available. We've got Aladdin on here.
Dumbo's on here.
Oh,
you could watch Dumbo.
I could not.
Oh my god, there's 117 films.
Oh, there's Hustle on here.
The film?
Yeah. Oh, no, not that one. So my only complaint about Virgin is their touchscreen's a bit fiddly.
Hidden Figures is really good.
No, I've seen that. It's pretty good. Got Detective Pikachu on here. Rocket Man. I haven't seen Rocket Man.
Oh, I love Rocket Man. I watched it again last week.
I'll give that a go. Oh, there's loads of things on here I'm really looking forward to. Today's menu, we've got stir-fried pork, chicken and mushroom casserole, and asparagus and potato gnocchi. We've both gone for this, and we chose this in the box. Also got a passion fruit slice, and Cajun pasta salad to start.
Ooh, cheese love. And crackers, I've got my lactose pills.
Oh yeah, treat yourself. So there's a nice pocket. It includes a little information pocket about the Wi-Fi, so it's $2.99 for like a messaging pack, $6.99 for like a continuous hour of service, and then $20.99 for the whole flight. So. I bought the whole flight one, and I'll let you know about like what the speed was like, because I think they bought it once before, but it was cheaper. I think it was like £15 before, and I never told you about it. So I'll try my best. Please remind me to tell the people about the Wi-Fi. You're looking at the magazine.
This Teddy, this is a dog from Instagram, and he's got his own merch. I love the hustle. Shout out to you, Boo.
So they have a control that pops out. So if you want to play games or control the television via your remote, you can. Lala, lala. There's a little table in the middle for our drinks and knickknacks and stuff.
And the shopping thing.
Shopping thing, and plenty of leg room. Lots and lots of leg room. Our tray is also in the side.
Hello. Adam's gone to the toilet, and I just wanted to say, thank you so much. This makes flying for me so much easier. As I said before, I'm not afraid of flying, but I just find it so uncomfortable and a nuisance and just don't like it. Even my apple juice is in a glass, an actual glass. I mean, this peasant from South London has never been treated so good, so. Thank you, Adam. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Don't cry.
Here's to a magical holiday, Gary.
Game on.
Don't look at the screen. Worst cards ever.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. I like the fairy.
Thank you. It stops the wind creating a muffly noise. In a premium economy meal, you get two glasses with a knife and fork in the middle for any wine or soft drinks. We both went for Coke. You also get a bottle of water, a cheesecake. This is a Cajun pasta salad, cheese and biscuits, a bread roll, and we've both gone for the gnocchi.
Yeah, and it's all ceramic.
Yep.
And glass.
Proper knife and fork as well. And there's adorable little salt and pepper shakers, which are a fan favourite on premium economy. And also upper class.
That's nice. For a veggie dish, that's really good.
This dessert, the passion fruit cheesecake, fantastic. Really, really good. Gary very kindly gave me his butter because mine was underneath my hot dish and just melted. So there's a little butter puddle underneath my bowl.
We're going to Disney World.
Oh, Alan there, where are you going? Disney World too?
I think the air pressure's got to you.
Yes.
On the bottom of the feet it says pinched from Virgin Atlantic. That's so funny. You are allowed to keep them.
Yep.
We just ran into the lovely Tash and Richard at 10,000 feet in the air. Gary was going to the toilet. Yeah, and it got spotted. So
photo shoot.
Had a little photo shoot.
She had your book.
She had my book, so I signed it for her, which is really lovely. We're now getting ready for tea and coffee. Proper cups, proper mugs. And we've also got
Detective Pikachu lined up.
We're going to watch that one together because neither of us have seen it. And we both love Ryan Reynolds.
Love Ryan Reynolds. Love Pikachu with his little like hat on and stuff.
Should be good. And I'm just beaming. I'm absolutely adoring this flight.
Oh, tea coffee. See you later, guys.
Look at these adorable mugs. They are lovely.
Can I keep the mug though?
You can't keep the mug, no. So I haven't brought my fear odds this time. I've actually gone for this Tech Net power bank. I can't remember how much it was. I think it was maybe, I think it was $15.90 or something like that. It wasn't expensive, and it's got like four chargers worth in it, and it also has lightning charge, or like rapid charge for Google Pixels. If I can find the link, I'll put it below. I will do a proper review of it. So far so good, it's pretty good. And it's a nice compact size as well. That's all I have to update you on right now.
Pikachu.
On Virgin Atlantic they have a little snack. Oh, it's very well presented, Elizabeth. It's very well presented. Skittles though, treat yourself.
Let's put them up the right way.
I'm a perfectionist as well.
So that selection, that's for upstairs, and they have another Wonderwall downstairs, and it's called Wonder, as in like W-A-N-D-E-R, so like if you're going for a Wonder, then you can go and pick up a little snack, and it's all included and free. So it's a nice little selection of like chocolate bars, biscuits, sweets and stuff like that, which you can help yourself to during the flight.
We've got about 3.5 hours left of our flight.
So far so good, I would say.
Yeah, good.
Yeah,
but the apart from me not locking the door properly and some woman walking in when I'm going to the toilet.
Such a melon. Cabin crew are really nice. Who's that? Looking after us? Ashley and
Elizabeth and Ashley.
Elizabeth. Really lovely. We've been chatting to Ashley for a bit. Food, what did you think?
I really liked the food.
It was nice.
It wasn't, I would never choose, but I actually really enjoyed it.
It was nice. I actually enjoyed it. But it wasn't, like Gary said, it wasn't what I would choose. It wasn't kind of the menu I was kind of hoping for. But it's still nice for what we had.
I'm playing Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. See?
You're ready for him to fail miserably. So when we arrive, we are taking the Magical Express over to our resort. And what are you looking forward to?
Star Wars Land? I just got a question about Star Wars. Who inherited Jedi powers? And it was all these random names in Luke Skywalker. Needless to say, I got it right.
He's won £100 so far.
This is what I call mile high tea. We've got a scone, chocolate eclair, macaron, cream, salmon sandwiches here, mozzarella and pesto sandwiches here.
Yep.
And tea as well. Oh, you do treat us right.
We do.
Lovely.
When I was a kid, we went to a little cottage stay place with the Banbury. And they had little marmalade, and I thought it was so cute that I kept it for 20 odd years.
Are you going to keep your strawberry jam for 20 odd years?
I'm not that Gary-y anymore. I'm more of a hoarder. I'm having everyone's.
I'm having everything. So, yeah, they're a very nice selection. In economy, you get a small box, which includes, I think, a mini scone and I think a mozzarella and tomato sandwich. But yeah, very nice selection. And it's by a certain chef, isn't it? What's his name?
Yeah.
Eric Landlord. Landlord?
Where are you greeting him?
I'm also watching Ugly Betty right now because I'm living my best life. Oh my god.
we could hear music. Listen, there's a gentleman over the other side who's got his headphones on. He's playing the song out of his phone. The stewardess came over and was like,
excuse me, sir, that's coming out of your phone. He just sat with his headphones on like...
I've really enjoyed this flight. It's been nice. Gary likes the Wi-Fi.
Yeah, I've paid for it the whole time next to it.
Worth it?
Oh yeah, like I did $6.99 for an hour, and then I did $6.99 for an hour, but it's $20.99 for the whole flight. It's like £21 to have your phone.
Yeah.
And I can just kill time like that on my phone. I can go on TikTok, Instagram, Twitter.
I've had it, and it's just been nice to like check in.
Yeah.
So worth it, I would say. And yeah. It's a reasonable speed as well. It's like you can watch videos on it.
Well, yeah, you're not supposed to watch like Netflix or anything because I think it pulls too much on it.
Mm.
But like short videos on YouTube work, on Instagram, TikTok work, Instagram videos work, your stories work.
Good.
All kills time.
How long we got?
We got an hour left.
Hello Disney World!
Not that Hello Disney World!
That hour, it did go quick. I can see land now.
Can you?
Yeah.
And rolling.
It's magic band time. We're coming into the land in approximately 45 minutes. So the descent starts in about 10 minutes. Struggling with the controls.
If you're watching the live premiere right now, hey girls!
Oh, we struggled to get that one down.
He was like, left, right. Just like that, we're a stone's throw away from Star Wars Land. I will stop talking about Star Wars Land because you've seen it. I won't.
Back it up.
Don't. We're walking down the jetway and we can already feel the heat, but we've got to leave you now because it's security.
Get that fan out now.
Found the carpet, which can only mean one thing. We're in Orlando.
Welcome to the city.
We are two of the 75 million visitors.
We count as more than one night. We've been
a more. Well, not in the same year. Well, I have, but you know what. They were playing that on the plane that's now stuck in our heads.
Okay. Steady cam.
Steady cam.
I'm going to take a picture. Got it. That's all I need.
Up.
Oh, feel that humidity.
I felt that humidity for a second there. Woohoo! I can't remember what it is, the airport, the Disney store here, is currently being refurbished. So they've got a big wall up around that, so hopefully it'll be back bigger and brighter and better. Magical Express, we're going to Disney World.
In 9 days you say tragical.
You got it?
Yeah.
You got it? You haven't got it.
It nearly pulled me down with it. That's gravity for you. Gravity!
Okay, so we're nearly at the Magical Express.
Oh, this is it. This is the most important part. This is it.
Out of all the resorts that we've stayed at, what do you think is probably your favourite?
Oh, Port Orleans.
Port Orleans Riverside?
Oh, yeah.
It's a good thing we're staying there then, isn't it?
No, we're not. Are we?
Yeah.
How many surprises? Are we actually though?
Yeah.
I've already got a pin for that. Don't need to get another one. Oh wow.
Yeah, so Port Orleans Riverside. I don't know what room type we're in. I think I've just got a standard one for now.
Oh wow.
But we loved it so much. And Pop Century's good, but I just didn't want to do the whole bed up, bed down every single day. It's nice to have the extra sink when we're there for so long. So and we love it.
So, you know, thank you so much. You ain't getting any
pleasure.
Tears though. I will cry as soon as the camera goes
Swine.
Up. That means I win.
Similar to last time, everybody knew. Rachel knew. I think Brogan knew.
Did they know about the premium economy as well?
Yeah. We've got a very good friendship group for
I'm
keeping these secrets.
To ring up Rachel and go, I found out about everything. Anything else? I'll sleep well tonight. I've gone through all the emotions.
Emotional roller coaster. Are you happy with the surprise?
Very happy.
Okay.
I've got sore eyes that I'm not crying.
I was a little bit worried because I was like, we have stayed there before.
I didn't know
if that was going to have a...
So when I said my favourite resort was Riverside, and you were like, I'm telling him now.
No, I'd planned that.
Oh, okay.
So I planned...
So what if I'd have said, out of animation?
Well, I've confirmed this on multiple occasions, on multiple Skype conversations before we even came.
Oh, okay.
Like, well, what would you say is your favourite resort? So I was thinking, like, how am I going to surprise you and do it really well?
Oh, I know exactly the... Yeah, I remember now. That's the one with its own little pools and stuff.
Own little pools. The nice quick service is nice and big. They do the really nice pasta dishes.
Ooh, yeah, we like it.
They do a good breakfast.
You get a boat to Disney Springs.
You get a boat to Disney Springs. Which is why I was like, yeah, we do Disney Springs tomorrow. Disney Springs
which
tomorrow.
Which means tomorrow afternoon we can get the boat back. Because we'll be there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You don't know that yet, though.
I've been planning
that's
it.
That's the next video.
Don't forget to subscribe below to see all this new content.
Hit the notification bell.
Hit the notification bell. This is what I like to see. No one in line for the Magical Express. And I had to do it before this point because the person whoever here like scans the Magiman would have given it away.
Oh, this is where you got me last time.
Yeah, I know.
This is the exact spot. So it's slightly early this time.
I'm a clever ruse.
I feel like there's a tear trapped in there. Like, I want to cry because I'm so emotional and vulnerable right now. And yet, there's a tear just behind because my eyes are really sore because I keep scratching them because I left my anxiety ring in the hotel in London because I'm an idiot.
We'll find you a Rubik's Cube or something to carry
we'll
in your pocket.
Yeah, a Rubik's Cube or just a stone on the floor, a pebble to play with. like a dog that's got no good toys. But this is the Magic Express over there.
This is when you feel the heat.
Oh no, I forgot about that.
Welcome back to Orlando. We're on a Mears coloured bus today, but it's fine.
I managed to get through the premium economy surprise.
Yeah.
I then was like, oh, was it a good surprise? Did you suspect anything? You said no. And I was like, okay, good, he has no idea. Did you suspect anything about this?
No.
I was thinking about buying the Pop Century pin once we dropped our bags and we're having a mooch around. I was like,
I didn't want to break your heart by not letting you being able to buy a pin.
Well, I've got the Port Orleans pin, so you've saved me money.
Or helped you from an addiction that you had.
Or, unless they've got a new one, because that was a couple of years ago.
And so it continues.
And I know, because in my Dropbox I've got pictures of all my pins, so I know what I've got and what I haven't got.
And yeah, is anybody else out in the world as bad as Gary when it comes to pins?
And don't forget, folks, I've already bought two pins from the Harry Potter shop.
We haven't even got there yet.
No.
Well, we're on the bus, Magical Express. It's a new coach, but there's no decal on the outside, and it looks like
from where they might have like taken it off to make it a new one. So,
yeah, who knows? But I'm very excited about Riverside. Dire keeping it secret.
What? Was that the 2016 we went there?
Yeah. That was it's one of my favourite resorts, and it's what I could afford.
So
for a really
we'll
nice
see.
Upgrade, and yeah,
Result tour.
Get
out, take a picture of that. Get out, take a picture of it, and be like, we're on this.
I'm on my way from misery to Disney today.
Still trying not to cry. As soon as the man said, which one are you going to?
Sounds like Balamori. Which resort are you going to? Tell me, what do you think?
I'm sending my mum this picture now. That's Port Orleans, number 5. And she
She knew I was going to Pop Century because I said, oh, they've got a giant Rubik's Cube, they've got all this stuff from the 80s, I can't wait to see it all.
This is what happened last time, you looked up All Star Sports and you're like, oh my god, I don't have a research to probably Riverside.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Walt Disney World Resort. Da 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 da, when you wish upon a star.
Makes no difference who you are.
Alright, sing along Sue, enough of you.
Enough of you, sing along Sue.
We're here, we're on Disney property, it's only taken 12 hours, but that flight, blew by.
Great flight.
Get it?
I don't know if we said about Elizabeth and Ashley, good work Virgin, but thank you so much.
I think we did. If not, amazing crew. Really, really lovely.
Really lovely flight. And thank you for booking the flight.
My pleasure. So we've got some dollars out to tip the driver. We normally do $2 per person, just as like a little gesture to say,
thanks for driving us.
And now that I've seen Hamilton, I know who all the founding fathers are. Washington was my favourite one. Just to let you know.
Nine nights of
this. Once we've got there, the main stop, I'll send everybody off the coast. Once everybody's off the coast, I'll go and grab your luggage and you guys can go on your way. Thank you guys for choosing Disney Magic Moon Express. Have a wonderful vacation.
Thank you, driver.
Oh, you're at the perfect time for the sunset as well.
It's beautiful. Well, it looks beautiful in any light, but I'll take it when it's most beautiful.
Almost like the sun day.
I'm hoping it's like this. But it's definitely not going to be 32 now in the afternoon. No, let me find out for you. The temperature currently, Mr. Gary C, is 30 degrees Celsius, so...
It's not going to be that far off this.
No.
It's alright.
Bearable. But bearing in mind it's not sunny, so...
Let's hope it stays sunny.
It's alright, we've got our 1-2 Beyonce fans anyway.
Oh yeah.
He's got the one from the last holiday and I've got a brand new blue one.
Because you're extra.
I do. I like when the Gary C colours.
Well, this doesn't look like Pop Century, does it?
I'm so confused. Where am I?
Thank you.
Hello. Thank you. You got it? Sorry. The fountain's gone. This is the part where Gary just walks out the front door. Well, I'm gone.
That's it, back to Pop Century. Oh, this one still looks the same though.
Oh, this is so beautiful. It's beautiful, darling.
Oh, we've got new little chairs to sit on.
They have.
And they've got new outfits.
Nice little chaise.
They didn't wear purple last time.
Hi! We're checking in, please.
Okay, I can give you at the station right.
Thank you. So pretty!
Oh, I love it. I do love a chandelier. Might I missed out on the fountain, but I did get the chandelier.
They might be refurbishing the fountain or something, who knows.
I just took it out and went clean it up. Give it a bit of a polish. And back it goes.
We're all checked in. We just got checked in by the lovely cast member Caitlin at the front desk. So I'd requested a Magnolia Bend room. So we've got a standard garden view. And requested Magnolia Bend, which is like the plantation type buildings here. They do have another area called, I don't know why I'm doing this when I just have a map in my pocket. Could you hold that for a second, please?
It's raining.
We're currently waiting for the...
I hate to be the bearer of bleakness, but it's raining. However, look how beautiful it looks out there. Nowhere else on earth looks this good when it rains.
So these are all Alligator Bayou rooms. They have a different style. I requested to be in one of these buildings in a standard room, simply because they've got like a different style, it's a little bit more regal, and just, it's the same price, and they look slightly better in my opinion. So I requested a Magnolia Bend, which is this building over here, and we had got that, but then she said, oh, wait here for me, went away, came back.
And now we're royalty.
And now we're royalty. She was like, I've been able to get you a free upgrade into a royal guest room.
So... Best day ever. I'm living the life.
That was a surprise for me. I was involved in that surprise.
That's the good karma for you giving the surprises to me.
Well. Like, I really wanted to stay in a standard room, but at the same time, if she's going to come here and give us a free upgrade, I'm not going to say no.
No, let's live our best lives.
Does it stop?
It's slowing down.
Still right in a minute.
Get ready to rush.
So yeah, we're gonna teeter over and
check into our new room.
Our new room.
I'm so excited.
Base camp.
Now I'm gonna cry.
Base bank. Base camp for the next 9 nights.
Yeah. Mo sugar.
Treat myself.
Treat yourself.
All the catchphrases.
Oh, feel that humidity. Let me give you a hand.
I thought that I would clear it.
Oh, oh, big strong man. We can either go that way, or we can go that way past the main pool. Have a little look. Gary has got a new case.
The one that's being loud is Adam's case.
No, it's not.
That is loud.
That one's being louder.
Is it? It's like a symphony of chaos and I love it.
I can't believe we're staying here for 9 nights. I'm so excited. The parks.
Plants, it's really fresh.
Plants, yeah. This is the Florida smell. This is the smell I miss so much.
Oh, that's a really...
We've got 9 nights to get that picture if you want.
Yeah, it looks lovely. Look at the sky over there.
The good thing about Port Orleans, Riverside and French Quarter is they have boat service to Disney Springs. Oh, it's so fantastic.
Wow. Look at that. Let's get that.
I'm already like tearing up thinking like I'm gonna be really upset to watch this back.
Why?
And edit it and be like,
I'm not there.
I wish
anymore.
I was there.
Oh wow, that's a lovely, lovely sky. Lovely sky.
Claire, if you're watching. All the love to you, girl. But she loves the sky, that one.
She does love the sky. But there's nowhere else in the world you get Florida sky like this. So
I just can't beat the smell. It's like a pine air freshener.
But better.
But clean.
We just passed the building and they're doing some construction. It looks like they're refurbishing like the standard and garden view rooms. So that could have potentially played into how we managed to get a free upgrade. Treat ourselves.
Hashtag, thanks Caitlin.
Yeah. Hey girl.
Hey girl.
So I don't know the name of the building that we're staying in, but we're
heading there. There was a shorter route just across the bridge in the far distance, but we decided to have a little walk through with our cases. Give Gary a little bit of extra work to do.
Get them legs ready for tomorrow. The Star Wars land.
We're in Parterre Place.
Parterre Place.
Is it a parterre?
Parterre, don't forget I'm French.
Parterre. They do private wagon rides in the evening here. Can't remember how much they are. I know they're not cheap, but if looking for a romantic thing to do in the evening, definitely an option. So I think we're approaching our room and we're on like the main bit right in front of the main building. So we can just walk right down the middle.
Oh, that's good.
And just come straight to the room here.
Oh, what did you say?
555? 558. 558, literally. Couldn't have got a better room. Oh my god, she pulled out the stops.
She did a good one. Good one, Caitlin.
and her manager, who she went to, the room organiser. Right, you go ahead, you do the tap tap. Let the magic begin.
Aircon.
Oh, here we go.
Ta-da!
Oh my god, it's so much bigger than I remember. It's huge!
Really big.
Oh my god, right, you take the camera, you can do a little...
This is what I really like. I really like the characters everywhere and the little touches. So you've got this little letter here. Welcome all. We are so excited to have you stay with us. My friends and I have shared so many wonderful moments here that this has become a very special place in our hearts. We love Princess Tiana. She's one of my favourite people to meet. And now... Oh, look at him. He's right there. He loves these rooms. Hooray! But look at all the little touches.
I don't think I've been this happy coming into a Disney hotel room in years.
But look at all the little touches. You have a little Cinderella theme.
Oh, the bathroom's my favourite bit!
He likes having two sinks. Tiana.
Love having two saves.
Characters for me.
There's Genie's lamp as the tap.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I remember that. Genie's lamp as the tap. Oh, wow.
Like, they've got like the Bayou flowers.
Yeah, and then you've got Pascal, Sebastian. I don't know if that's focusing on that because of the light difference.
I'll look in the bathroom. Let me.
Loads of characters.
Thank you.
That's it.
In the bathroom, we've got this lovely regal curtain. Loved it. I remember the showers. I don't know why I'm holding this. I remember the shower head being beautiful, darling. Darling! They've got the new things, the pumps. So they're reducing the use of single-use plastic. I'm all for that. Save the planet, save the turtles. Nice little couple ledges in the bathroom, which I think they may have added. I definitely don't remember those being there before, because I remember storing all our stuff there in 2016. So this is hello. Picture of me. This is the exact same setup as we had, like the same layout we had for the last time, and the same way around.
But I forgot the Beauty and the Beast, the dog.
Footrest. Luggage rest, or whatever it is. But,
I know, God. I've got pictures of all of this, but I'm literally like, picture heaven!
It's so amazing. It seems so much bigger than last time.
I don't remember that, the tea above the bed.
For Tiana. I have a funny feeling that the ceiling feels higher.
Yeah, I think they're different.
Something's different, but look at that. Look at it's just gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
Oh, it was gorgeous. I think there's something we're missing.
What? Oh, the magic music.
I think I figured out why this room looks bigger. So you see this like shape here?
Maybe we've shrunk. Oh, we're such thin size now.
Let's not joke, okay? the rooms normally have an indent, don't they? So like, as you come round, they're all like indented.
This one's
but
open.
Because we're on the front of the building, this has got an extra bit. So you had this bed last time. Do you want the same bed again?
Yeah.
Because I remember you counted your stripper money last time. 2016 series is like my favourite thing.
Oh,
to watch
I bought a lot of pins that time.
That was when the addiction started, but
it was actually.
So, right, other things that we should mention. So there's a coffee machine of sorts. It's not like one of those proper Keurig ones, but you could brew some coffee in the room if you want to. Drawers
this
space.
This is the holiday where I actually use the drawers and stuff. And
we can unpack. Packs.
Yeah.
We're here for 9 nights. I can't believe we're here for 9 nights. Oh my God. This is crazy. we've got the princesses over here, and then a hairdryer down there, which is good. What else we got? Facial soap and a body lotion, tissues, bin and recycling bin, iron and ironing board, one of those very small safes, so you could probably fit a passport in there, but not big enough for a laptop, unfortunately. Spare pillows and hangers.
What?
The
magic carpet on the floor.
The magic carpet! I can show you the world. oh my God, I'm so happy.
Things to keep.
We're in Disney World!
Look, all the things to keep for the scrapbook, yeah!
What is it?
It's like a welcome letter and from the general manager.
Oh, that's nice.
And something, a quote from Walt Disney with a picture, a sketch picture. Oh, yeah, I have that.
Treat yourself.
Treat yourself. Goodbye, phone. For the gram! Don't look at me like that. I feel your judging eyes.
right, so we've got some nice little... Oh, yes, room occupied sign. So, room occupied sign, there is a policy behind this sign. A cast member is permitted to enter your room every 24 hours, or has to enter your room every 24 hours. Of course, they will call ahead and hi, say, sorry, we just need to do a security check, but you can't just leave your do not disturb sign on, basically, and never have someone check your room. They were doing a thing a year or two ago where they were asking if you wanted to refuse... Not room service, like housekeeping, but I can't remember if they carried that on or stopped it, but...
It was pretty for the season as well.
It probably was, and the fact that they were probably trying to cut...
Yeah, pretty low staff.
Cut back and stuff like that. So, no, it's a beautiful room, and I can't believe we're staying here. I don't know the difference between a standard room and a royal guest room. I think it's probably something you could very easily look up on the Walt Disney World website, but it's a considerable amount of money for like a 9-night stay, so I'm so flabbergasted they just upgraded us. It's so kind of them. So
pleased.
Very emotional right now. Why are you putting all your stuff on my bed?
Oh, is that your bed? This is where I put all my pins out that year. I thought this was my bed.
Yeah, but you still did it on my bed.
Oh, did I?
Oh gosh, I look a little bit worse for wear. I was looking at the viewfinder, I was like, oh.
Like 13 hours or something.
Well, we've been up for over 24 hours, easy.
Yeah.
Right, we're doing our unpacking jobs right now. These drawers are huge, by the way. Like, plenty of space in there. The bathroom is slowly coming together. You can... Oh God, so funny. I'm such a maniac for like stacking things in like a nice little
look
order.
Look how I did mine. Yeah, you're all right. Look at you.
What? It's my little thing. I like to get a little face cloth, put it down. That way, like, even though this is clean, this has the opportunity to just
add... I would
add
eat off this. It's that clean.
I know, but this adds an extra layer. And it means that when the cleaner comes in to do the room, all they have to do is pick that up, move it over.
How nice is that cold floor?
It's really nice, actually.
Oh, it's so good.
Oh, yeah. I picked this, if any gentlemen out there, I picked this up from Primark. I think it was only like £2 or something like that. And in there, it has a nice little comb, scissors, nail clippers, tweezers.
Very nice. In fact, most of the stuff that I got was from Primark.
I'm so afraid of the big bad one. The music's still going. Turn it off. The
it's
whole
a new. It's a new one from what we remember, but yeah. It's still lovely. So, because I got some of these like reusable bottles, so I didn't have to bring like the full ones. Because I like using my own shampoo, so I brought these little bottles, so I didn't have to bring the full thing, which is nice. Yeah, oh, made up. Right, we're gonna finish unpacking and then we're gonna head out for some food. Come along then.
Come along.
Oh, we have to remember that, 9558. But I think we're in a pretty good position to remember it. It looks like it's been raining again, yeah. It's all right at the moment, I think. I've got my flip-flops on. I've already got my trainers a bit wet. Those of you that are loyal to the channel will know all about my little tricks. Pack some flip-flops and then you can just walk out in the rain and they will dry in no time. You're not getting sodden trainers that you then have to dry out for days on end. Not for me, girl. Oh, what's
someone
you spotted?
Loves the fountain. You know what this means? Where is the fun?
I can't get over the smell. It's so nice.
Yeah.
It's delicious. So if we're ever getting lost, just find the Tiana sign, go straight that way.
Yeah,
there's a little throne there with a spotlight on it.
Ooh, get on that. Get pictures on that on the way back.
Yeah.
What? Oh, you're filming. don't let my secrets out.
I think this could be my favourite resort.
Oh, it's definitely mine so far.
I like how you slid in so far, implying that we're coming back. That Pinterest, or whatever? The building.
Yes.
About a 5-minute walk from the front, which is really good. Nice location.
Which is good for old Legs McGee.
Legs McGee. So one thing we have to do, we have to come and see the piano guy.
Oh, he was
here. Because we never got the chance to properly see him last time. We saw him in passing, but...
We've heard him.
I think he plays on Wednesdays, for sure.
Mm. Very chilled atmosphere in this one as well.
Yeah. It's a very nice family resort, I think.
Yeah. Pass again.
And I've heard very good things about boat rides. Hi. This is Portland's Riverside quick service. They've got lots of beverage stations over there. Lots of food stations as well. Desserts, subs, pizzas, chicken nuggets, burgers. Riverside Mill.
Really nice. Oh, this Riverside Mill, because it's got the mill on the side.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very cool.
See that, where it says Riverside. That reminds me of the token in front.
Yeah, it does look like it.
Ooh, spooky cups. Remember the quest for the Halloween cups last year?
2018, yeah.
No quest this year.
I don't know what colour I'm going to go for.
They do a Buzz Lightyear one. Or they do that one.
That's not Halloween, I think it's just generic Mickey. But, right, so if you haven't heard of these before, I can't remember how much they are. What's it say on there? They're like $16, $17, something like that, and you get free raffles for 2 weeks. Very handy. Very much recommend it for any family that's coming on. You get them free in the dining plan. But yeah, I don't know what colour I'm going to go for. I'm so torn.
Guess what we didn't bring with us?
What?
The bamboo straws.
That's okay, we can sip for now.
Alright.
Got our chicken Alfredos.
Cherry Coke, the best drink in the world.
This is the selection they've got at the moment. They've also got hot chocolate, napkins, ice, cutlery, iced tea, like butters and stuff in a fridge. I'm just starving now, I just need to eat this. Oh, I'm so hungry.
We didn't come here at Halloween though, did we?
No, we did that was June, when it was ridiculously way too hot. I like the fact you've got like a little dinner plate set up.
Yeah.
Please bite into the breadstick.
Just like my lovers.
What lovers?
This is fantastic. What do you think?
It's amazing, but if you're not a big eater, share it with someone. It's really
it doesn't
filling.
Look big, but it's very filling.
It's really filling.
Mm. Nice though. And with the breadstick as well.
The really nice bits of chicken that are in it.
Yeah, they are.
Nice. We're just talking about what we're going to be doing for the next few days, and we're changing it up a little bit. We're not going to do what we normally do, which is go straight to Magic Kingdom on the first day, and then do Epcot, then do Animal Kingdom, then do Hollywood Studios. We're planning on doing Star Wars Galaxy's Edge first thing tomorrow, spending the day at Hollywood Studios, and then we're going to go to Animal Kingdom after that, Epcot after that, and then Magic Kingdom when we go to Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. So,
oh, is that the first time we go?
Yeah.
So when it's all done up, you know what I'll be wearing.
Yeah, well, that's the first time we'll be going in and having like a Magic Kingdom Park day. So before then, we've got magical fun times.
Mm. Oh, I'm buzzing to be here. Buzz.
I'm just happy to be here.
Buzz.
I know I would normally get like French fries and barbecue sauce, but at the same time, I'm trying to put traditions secondary to trying different things. And that chicken Alfredo was pretty good. I liked it.
That was your first chicken Alfredo?
Very, very nice. I took my lactase tablet so I could have some dairy. And so far, so good.
Moo moo? Sure.
Sure. Beware the moo. Look how nice that is, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it used to have a really bad rep, but apparently it's on the up and up. And it's like a buffet style, like all you can eat style, I think. Yeah. Fulton's General Store. This is probably the best like resort merch store there is.
This store's amazing. And look what they have.
That's not the same thing you had last time, is it?
Oh, is it not?
I'm not sure. I thought the thing you had was like a cookie with icing on it.
It's worth it for the grind.
Look at this homeware stuff. This is lovely.
Oh, look what he is. See, this is his thing. Come here, you. That's his thing, homeware.
It's my kryptonite. These are lovely though. Look at those. Really nice. They're really nice. I mean, it's more display than it is an actual mug. That's like a china.
Surely that's not a mug.
I don't think so. It feels too vase-like.
Look how different they are.
The plates are lovely though. What are you on the hunt for?
Are they out of stock? They are not out of stock.
No, I don't think so. Gary's looking for the graham crackers we had. Last time before that?
They're my favourite Disney thing. Everybody goes on about the Rice Krispie cakes and everything, but for me it's the Minnie Mouse.
The graham crackers. Yeah, well they are.
They'll be here somewhere.
Oh look, they've got like Pride Rice Krispie cakes.
Got. I don't have the figment. My relationship with figment is troublesome. I'm going to say something you're never going to hear me say again. Let's leave this for now. Because we're going to Disney Springs tomorrow, that's where we're going to pinch out.
And there we hit the crux of the conversation. Got Huey, Dewey and Louie here. That's Chip over there. Oh, look! Kablammy! Aqua Arendelle. They don't miss a trick, do they, Disney? Ooh, this was quite fun, Magic Mirror.
The lady we just met said that she's been trotting around all of Disney World. Where did she say she found the ears?
No idea. Are they not here?
No, they've sold out. She said they've sold out everywhere and that she found them today somewhere.
Contemporary is always a good place for picking up limited edition stuff.
Because nobody thinks to go there.
No.
Cares. I love the hats. And they've got.
So I think you've missed a trick because you probably could have bought that hat and then had the Silla Pumpkin t-shirt on at the same time.
What if I buy it now and then I walk around with it, like try to extend the day a couple of hours? Girls.
They've got the little plush. Have you got. There's a Halloween Mickey up there.
I'm not actually collecting the plush anymore. I know. Because. I had so many that I've had to put them in storage and now I don't see them. It's like, well, I'm literally buying it to put it in a plastic bag in the loft. Do you know what I mean? Anyway.
Oh, it's so nice.
This hat is wicked. I could just buy it.
No, okay, well, you've already just given in to your one thing that you said not to do.
I'm not going to buy it. I'm going to get the hat. I don't know if I'm going to get the hat.
It's very expensive for a hat.
It is, but...
You're not going to wear it at home.
No. Maybe take a picture of me in it now, and then I can pretend that I bought it.
Yeah, right. They've got these new, like, sleeping character pillows that are in, like, their pyjamas, which is adorable. These are $34.99. And then the classic plush, like the medium-sized plush, is either $22 if you buy two, or individually, they are $26.99.
It's 22 for two?
When you buy two, yeah.
That's quite good.
No, $22 when you buy, like each, when you buy two. Yeah, it's not that good a deal.
I was going to say, I'll have four.
They've even started selling these buttons that are like, meet me at the people mover. If you don't believe me, you're in denial. Looking for more thingamabobs. These are quite cool. I think they're going off the Etsy trend. Those are $9.99.
Show the wares. I got the new Port Orleans pin because I have the old one, so it's on a new backing card. Can you see that?
There you go.
There you go. It's Tiana and it says Port Orleans, Riverside, because there is actually a Mickey and Minnie one for the French Quarter. And
she's happy she managed to get a new pin.
A new...
She substituted the one that she couldn't get from Pop Century.
A new resort pin. Who knew? They did new ones every now and then. So...
Well, you did, because she went to check.
And that's bloody to go to check. And that's on the white card as well, the new Disney Parks, like, general range, if you want to call it. But yeah, what a day.
Whew. It's been a fantastic day. This is possibly the best start to a trip we've ever had.
Yeah, day one. Welcome.
Premium economy. You got a surprise with an upgrade of a hotel. We both got a surprise with an upgrade of a room. Living our best life.
It's just so nice.
Much better than Pop Century. No offense, Pop Century. We love you still. Well, this evening's already taken a turn. I just saw something hop and I was like, oh my god, it's a frog, because I was trying to stop Gary. And then in the process, Gary stood on my flip-flop and then ripped it in half.
When I screamed, because I thought I was
being
attacked.
Where are you going?
I don't know.
This is
us. I'm staying in all of them, don't you know? I've got room in every patch.
Fear not, I managed to fix the flip-flop. What a day.
The frog flop.
It's been amazing. It's absolutely amazing. I can't believe we're in a royal guest room.
Yeah, here we are with Tiana.
Love hey it. Girls. Love it. So, thanks so much for coming along. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for the surprises and thank you for watching.
If you made it to the end of the vlog, chances are you've been watching for a long time. So, good job. Be sure to subscribe because new vlogs are on the way. We've got lots of new fun things planned. We're going to new places, new restaurants.
Where are we going tomorrow?
We're going to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Otherwise known as Star Wars Land by this one. And we've got reservations that are very hard to get. We've got a dessert party. We've got a special thing that Gary doesn't know about yet. So it's going to be a wild adventure and we can't wait to have you along. Check out our stuff in the links below. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to see all the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching and we will see you
tomorrow.